Let's go get him.
Give me that joy I can't explain. An extra piece that'll ease my pain. Want that love that'll never change. Give me that.
Give me that.
Give me that.
Give me that.
Give me that power to walk away. When another God wants to take your place. As much of you as I can take.
Whoa.
Give me that.
Give me
that.
Oh, oh, oh. Anybody ready?
Oh, oh, oh.
Ready for his glory.
Oh, oh, oh.
If you are sick of life,
oh, oh, oh.
Let me tell you the story.
Oh, oh, oh.
Every place that's dark,
oh, oh, oh.
He will bring it to light.
Oh, oh, oh.
Hypocritical hearts, backsliders, liars, time to get right.
Oh, oh, oh.
See, I include myself.
Oh, oh, oh.
I cast my own stone.
Oh, oh, oh.
The man in the mirror, y'all.
Oh, oh, oh.
I can see my wrong.
We're going to get ready to move forward. The subject today, three cheers for God. If you're going to cheer something, if you're going to cheer somebody, the cheer should be for God. Hip, hip, hooray. Three cheers for God. Text will be coming today from Ephesians chapter 1, primarily dealing with verses 3 through 14. Key verse will be verse 7. It reads as, in him we have redemption through his blood, the forgiveness of sins according to the riches of his grace. I'm going to read that one more time. In him we have redemption through his blood, the forgiveness of sins according to the riches of his grace. See, it ain't based on you and I, but God. But the blood of Jesus, we wouldn't have redemption. Because of that first Adam, because of the sin that Adam and Eve did way back then. We was born in sin.
Amen.
But we can give God cheers because he's already saved us from our sins through the blood of Jesus Christ. All we got to do is repent. The introduction. Have you ever noticed the changes that take place when you really get excited about something? People change when they're excited. When you're just going through with emotions, you're doing it one way. Man, you drop a few dollars on them, you're going to see them get excited. Throw some candy at the children, you're going to see them get excited.
Man,
we should be excited about God. We smile more. We move faster. We speak in greater effectiveness. It's amazing when somebody's excited, their whole tone changes. We feel like just shouting to the world. And I say, if you're going to shout about something, shout about God. Three cheers for God. For what he done for us. Even in our mess, even in our sins, he's taking care of us. He provided a way for us to get back to him through the blood of Jesus.
Amen.
Paul gives us a long song of praise in this passage. In fact, the whole text is one long sentence in the original language of the New Testament. His song should be sung. In a sense, he's saying three cheers for God. Hip, hip, hooray.
Amen.
If you're going to praise something, if you're going to praise somebody, praise God. Amen. Verse 3 tells us, blessed be the God and Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, who has blessed us with every spiritual blessing in heavenly places in Christ. Just as he chose us in him before the foundation of the world, that we should be holy and without blame before him in love. That's making it plain. See, he chose us, Brother Walter. He chose us, children. He chose us walk-ins. Predestined, before you was born, before you was thought of, God had already chose you. He'd already made a plan for you. Amen.
Amen.
Having predestined us to adoption as the sons by Jesus Christ to himself, according to the great pleasure of his will, to the praise and glories of his grace, by which he made us accepted in the beloved. See, through Jesus Christ, through the shedding of Jesus' blood, we've been made righteous, not by our own works, but by nothing we've done. So the first cheer should be a cheer of thank you, God, for choosing me. Thank you, God, that despite of my failures, despite of my shortcomings, that you chose me.
Yes, sir.
You took me off the B team and put me on the A team.
Yes, sir.
Unless they put me on the G team, God's team. Amen.
Amen.
God chooses those who choose his son. See, there's but one way. Man was cut off because of our sinfulness nature. That nature of sin that we was born in, because of all the wretchedness that was going on in the world and all the wrongdoing that was going on then, and we still know some going on now. God was so upset he cut us off, man. He didn't know what he was going to do with us. He was contemplating just giving up on us in a way. But Jesus said, I go. Let me go down there and show them and testify to them and teach them some godly characteristics.
Amen.
So there's but one way. If we want to get right with God, we got to get right with his son, Jesus.
Sir.
Wants you to know it is a privilege to be chosen. A Christian person, one that's been saved, one that has grace, one that has redemption, one that has an inheritance. Know that it's a blessing. A blessing that's not made with man's hands. There are some material things that we can be thankful for. There are some earthly things we can be thankful that we don't have. I ain't got to mention them. But there is something we surely should be thankful for, and that is that Jesus loved us, that God loved us so much that he gave his only begotten son, Jesus.
Yes, sir.
Who died for us on Calvary. Who shed his blood for us. Wants you to know it's a great responsibility to be chosen. It's a great responsibility. When we've been chosen and we've acknowledged that we've been chosen, there are some things that's expected of us. We should become co-laborers in sharing this good news. You don't have to be a preacher. You just say. You have Christ in you. You have the Holy Spirit in you, so you should be telling people about Jesus. People should see some excitement in you. You are co-laborers. Maybe your role is to tell somebody about this kitchen. Tell somebody about this great work that's going on. This great thing that's been done on 21st and West Rose. There's some kingdom building going on. Some good soul food being cooked. Physical food and spiritual food. But what's most important is the spiritual food. When you're saved, you have a responsibility to tell them that man can't live by bread alone. That it's God's word that saves us. And that physical meal just gives you a little energy. Helps you to get by for a little while. But that word of God, if you take it in, it can sustain you, man. It can determine your salvation. Most of all, it's a great joy to be chosen. A Christian person. Thinking about Mother Hughes out there in her youth. I look at her and just see how vibrant she is and how the Lord has given her good health and strength and portion of a right mind. She on better foundation than most of the young folks in here. Been serving God most of her life. When she came back into fellowship with New Mount Olive, a few weeks ago, she said, I was with Pastor Echols back at Double Bridges. She'd been part of the family longer than most of us been alive. It's a great joy. She's excited about it. First to get in here most days. Last week at discipleship class, first to get here at the building. Standing outside waiting on everybody else. Leading by example.
Yes, sir.
You ain't got to drag her out to discipleship class. You ain't got to trick her here. You ain't got to bribe her here. She was the first one to get here. Most days in the kitchen. She was the first one to get here. Setting the right example. Joyful to be among godly people around our church family living a righteous life. The second cheer, thank you God for saving me. Saving me. We ain't talking about physical. We're talking about spiritual. We're talking about your salvation. We're talking about your eternal salvation. Want you to know this body came from dust and it's going back to dust. We wearing out a little bit every day. Ask some of these golden girls. Ask Deacon Middlebrook. Every day you get up, something wearing out on you. But you're excited because spiritually, when you're in the body of Christ, you're stronger than you've ever been. You're vibrant.
Amen.
Heaven predestined us to adoption as sons by Jesus Christ to himself, according to the good pleasures of his will, to the praise of the glory of his grace, by which he made us accepted in the beloved. In him we have redemption through his blood, the forgiveness of sins according to the riches of his grace, which is made to abound towards us in all wisdom and purity, having made known to us the mystery of his will, according to his good pleasures, which he is purposed in himself, that in the disposition of the fullness of the time, he might gather together in one all things in Christ. Here, at some time, we're going to all come together. 1 Corinthians 3:22, whether Paul or Apollos, or the world or life or death, all things present or things to come, all of yours, they all belong to God. We're all his creation, regardless of where we stand. Whether you're a believer or an unbeliever, whether you're saved or unsaved, whether you're sinner or righteous, he's already claimed you. He's already chose you. All you have to do is choose him. Can't make it no easier than that. The second cheer. Thank you, God, for saving us. Savior for you if you hadn't accepted him or just right in front of you. All you got to do is accept it. It's a gift. The price has been paid already. Jesus shed his blood over 2,000 years for your sins. He paid your debt. Paid it with his life. We have been adopted into the family of God.
Amen.
How do we know that? Ephesians 4:1 tells us. Ephesians 1:4 tells us. Heaven predestined us to adoptions as sons by Jesus Christ to himself, according to the good pleasures of his will. Can't make it no plainer than that. We are blessed. We have been redeemed from the bondage of sin. Now there was a time it was based on us. It was based on judges. It was based on you better do right. You better get it all right. We're sharing with the group last week on the judges. During Moses' time, it didn't take but two or three going to tell on you if you was messing up. And you'd go before that judge, and he'd look you up and down, listen to the sin you had committed, and then he'd decide how he was going to deal with you. Man, it could cost you your life. Because your hands was in another man's hands. Your hands was in the ones who wouldn't told on you. And sometimes they would exaggerate a little bit. You know how we is. I saw them. They did it. They guilty. They gonna tell everything you did. They ain't gonna tell how they saw you because they was out there too.
Yes, sir.
How did they know what you were smoking? Because they know what the smell is. How did they know what you were drinking? They know what it tastes like and what it smells like, but they wasn't telling that part. They was telling on you. So we had to come up with a better system. God decided to send his son Jesus. And we created a new covenant. That it wasn't just based on man's word. It wasn't just based on deeds. Because if it was based on deeds, the flesh, we wouldn't make it. We'd all fail. And since he had pre-adopted us, he had predestined us to be reunited with us through his son Jesus. He had to make it a little clearer, a little easier. It wasn't based on you and I. It was based on Jesus. But we were asked to accept and believe in Jesus. Believe that he was born of a virgin. Believe that he lived here on earth. Believe that he descended from heaven to come to earth. Believe that he had an earthly ministry. Believe that he preached and he taught and he shared the word. Believe that he suffered for us. Believe that they hung him on the cross. They nailed nails in his hands and pierced his side and nails in his feet. Believe that he bled. That blood, you have to believe in. That blood that flowed from his body. That blood washed us. It washed me. It washed the first lady. It washed the pastor. It washed the body of Christ.
Amen.
It washed those who haven't accepted him yet. He's still allowing you time. He's putting you around some godly people, putting you around some solid word, some foundational truths. But it's up to you to receive it. We had been forgiven from the penalty of sin. I'm getting close. Galatians 4, verses 4 through 9 tells us, but when the fullness of time had come, God sent forth his son, born of a woman, born under the law, to redeem those who were under the law, that we might receive adoption as sons. Can I make it any plainer than that? And because you are sons, God has sent forth the spirit of his son into your hearts, crying out, Abba, Father. Therefore, you are no longer slaves, but a son. And if a son, then an heir of God through Christ. I love it when Reverend Lee said, beloved, you're more than a conqueror through Jesus Christ. You're blessed. We have the greatest gift that man can have. And if we believe in him, we have the Holy Spirit indwelled in us. He's given us a comforter. We have no excuse. Whatever trials is coming your way, whatever tribulations is coming your way, the path is clear. The problem is we're ignoring the path. We want to go our own way. Because the holy way, the Holy Spirit way, is not conducive and don't make your flesh feel good. He ain't worried about your feelings. He's worried about your heart. Is it right? He's worried about, are you focusing on godly things? Are you moving towards Jesus? Because you know he's coming back. If he left, and when he left us a guarantee. He may make a down payment. Why would God have to make a down payment? You go to get a car, they want a little down payment. You go to get a house, they want a little honest money. But this is God. If he made it all, if he pre-existed it all, if he created it all, why would he have to make a down payment? He did that because he loved you and he wanted to make it plain for you. The down payment was the Holy Spirit. He said he ain't gonna leave you lonely. He told the apostles to go back to the upper room and wait. I'm gonna send you a comforter. That same comforter is in us who believe in him. So when you have to make them choices, they are choices. Whether you make the bad one, sin, or the right one, righteousness. It was a choice. You wasn't put in no situation you didn't have no choice in. People say all the time, man, you put me in a corner, I had to do it. That's not true. You made a conscious decision to deny the Holy Spirit and please your flesh. Because sometimes to get out of a situation, all you got to do is let go and let God. All you got to do is back away. I ain't got to prove how tough I am. I ain't got to prove I can fight. I ain't got to prove my manhood. I ain't no punk. I ain't no chump. We serve a God that will fight our battles. We serve a God who's already fought the battle and won the battle. They didn't take his life. He laid it down. So what you got to prove to an earthly person? Somebody that don't believe in nothing. A Christian person don't have no business out there trying to measure up to an earthly person who believes in nothing but himself. And you have a Holy Spirit. You have a battler. You have a warrior. You have a doctor. You have a lawyer. You have a friend. You have a lily of the valley. You have a bright and morning star. They call him wonderful. Jesus Christ. He can do it all. But you got to trust him. The third cheer. Thank you, God, for sharing with me. Sharing with me. I'm getting close. In him, you also trusted. After you heard the word of truth, the gospel of your salvation. And those who also haven't believed, you were sealed with the Holy Spirit of promise, who is the guarantee of our inheritance until the redemption of the purchase possession. And the purchase possession is us. He's coming back for us. He's already paid for us, so he's coming back for us. To the praise of his glory.
Amen.
So the third cheer should be, thank you, God, for sharing with me. Letting me know that in advance the debt has been paid, the captives have been set free, that there's no more slavery to sin. I don't have to follow the flesh. I don't have to be on the broad road. I can be on the narrow road. I don't have to linger in darkness, man. I can lay and live in the light. This thing that we do. God does not just save us and then leave us alone. He left us the Holy Spirit. He has shared with us the gift of the Holy Spirit so that we might grow in faith. If you say you believe in him, you should be growing. You should be transitioning. You shouldn't be standing still. If you're dealing with the same mess you was dealing with 10 years ago and you say you believe in Jesus, you need to recheck yourself.
Amen.
You need to reevaluate. That don't mean you got it all right. That don't mean you ain't gonna make no mistakes, but you should be growing. You should be transitioning. The Holy Spirit is the Father's mark of ownership of us. He's talking to you. I had a brother ask me at work the other day. He's dealing with some things and he was worried about it. He said, Mike, I pray all the time, but how do I know the Holy Spirit is really moving me? I said, you got to trust him. The fact that you're praying to him and you're asking him tells you right there that you believe in it. Some won't stop to pray. Now, while we're praying, we can't be telling him what we want and how we want it. We got to allow to move it the way he want to move it, to work it out to his will. It ain't always going to work out the way you want. I love it when Reverend Ed makes it plain. You better watch what you pray for. You asking him to fix it, you might not like the way he going to fix it. But I guarantee you this, he is going to fix it. It's going to come out just the way he want it. You can believe that. The Holy Spirit is the Father's promise for fellowship. I love it. I love knowing that I have a comforter right here beside me, right here with me, that's breathing up my neck. I can feel him some days when that devil is out there getting in my way and trying to set blocks for me, that I serve one who's got my back, that he's allowing me to see it clearly. Sometimes I want to go this way, but I have to stop and really pray again and really meditate on what he wants me to do, and I end up going a total different direction. And it looks like the wrong way, it feels like the wrong way, but in the end you see that it was his plan for you. It wasn't fun, it wasn't easy, it was coarse, it was difficult. Because it comes with long suffering. It comes with denying yourself. It comes with knowing that it's not about you, it's about him. It's about Jesus. It's about kingdom building. So as we close, if you've never accepted Jesus Christ as head of your life, but today Reverend Mike has made it plain, we should be giving God three cheers.
Amen.
Thanking him for loving us.
Amen.
Thanking him for choosing us.
Amen.
Thanking him for saving us.
Amen.
Thanking him for sharing with us the Holy Spirit. But you haven't experienced that because you never accepted him as Lord and Savior. But today you want to get on the good ship. You want to get on that this ride that we're on, this train that we're on, that's leading us to Jesus. And you want to accept Jesus as your Lord and Savior. Today could be your day. If you've never accepted Jesus as Lord and Savior, but Reverend Mike has made it plain, and today you want to accept him, all you got to do is raise your hand. Then we have one. Amen. Don't get caught up on the food. Don't get caught up on the distractions. Think about where you stand. He's chose you. Have you chosen him? Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Maybe you've chosen it. Maybe you believe in it. Maybe you've already confessed that you believe in Jesus Christ. You know he was born of a woman. You know he's Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. You know that he suffered. You know that he died. You know they buried him. You know he rose. You know he's coming back. But some way, you're still on the right path, but you slowed down. You become stagnated. Things have gotten in your way. The world is pulling you. And you operate more in the physical than in the spiritual. And you want to repent right now. You want to be made new again. You want to be fresh again. You want to have vigor again. You want flavor again in your soul. This could be your moment. Do we have anybody that want to come for repentance or prayer? All you got to do is raise your hands. Amen. We've got two. Amen. We've got two. Let's give God a hand. Amen. Anybody else? Hey, we ain't in the feeding business. We're in the soul-saving business. And he's working. He's working. Amen. The two that ask for prayer, we're going to ask that you come down and we're going to pray for you. And anybody else that would like to be prayed for, we're going to ask that you come down and we're going to pray for you as well. God is working here at Newmont Olive. He's making a difference in lives. People are being saved, they're being transformed. I'm going to ask Reverend Ed if he can. Can you give us a moment? Come down and pray for us. Anybody else? You don't have to be left out. You don't have to be left in the cold. Amen. This is a family thing. Amen. Let's give Reverend Ed a hand as he comes.
All right. Good word. Good word today.
Amen.
It ain't bad. It's true. That word is true.
Amen.
All right.
Amen. Got another young brother come down. Let's give God a hand. He's seeing young people move. Amen. Tell me this thing ain't going out. The Lord is working.
Father, again, we do thank you for this opportunity, this privilege. We thank you for Reverend Mike, Lord, and the word that he just have shared.
Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord.
Pray for those that have come forward. Lord, you know how that what each one needs, Lord. You know the amazing thing.
Yes,
you know each one of us. You know us personally. You know our inside and out. And we just pray that you meet the need that each of us stand in need of. We pray for the listeners today, Lord. We just pray that you would continue to work in their hearts, Lord, to will and to do of your good pleasure. We thank you, Lord, for all that you are using Reverend Mike to do. Thank you for pastor. Thank you for this the great staff of cooks and all that is involved, Lord, in making this ministry possible. We thank you for each and every one of them. We pray, Lord, continually,
yes,
that your word would go forth, that it would accomplish that which you want to accomplish. And Lord, meet the need that each one stand in need of, Lord. I don't know the different need, but you know.
Yes, Lord.
And we pray for each one of them in the name of Jesus. Amen.
Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Three cheers for Jesus. Amen. God a hand again. Amen. Let's give our pastor in his absence. Let's give him a hand for his vision. Amen. Thank God for Reverend Ed, Reverend Doug. God has put us around some godly men that's teaching us the right way. And we're growing. You see it in the work that's going on here. You see it in young people coming down and humbling themselves and being renewed. I'm excited about it. Amen. God bless you. God hold you. God keep you. Amen.
Jesus, I want more of you. But I know there's got to be less of me.
Give me that joy I can't explain. I'm at a loss of words now. I'm so happy you make me happy now. Yeah. Give me that joy I can't explain. Add extra peace that'll add extra peace that'll ease the pain. I want that love that'll never change. Oh, give me that.
Give me that.
Give me that.
Give me that.